Hi, my name is Cornell Brooks. We're working in the NIH in the Clinical Center in the Department of Laboratory Medicine. Right now, we're studying hematological cancer, so blood leukemia, specifically acute myeloid leukemia. Well, I'm from Woodbridge, Virginia. I live in Woodbridge, Virginia, and I've always sort of been passionate about science since I was about in high school, but really I started really loving science when my dad made me read this book about Ben Carson. And Ben Carson is the first neurosurgeon to successfully separate two Siamese twins who are conjoined at the head. And that really sort of got me really active and engaged in science. Essentially what happens in these leukemias is that you have stem cells, blood stem cells, and all these cells grow and develop into any sort of cell. They have a target cell. So somewhere along this development, there's a mistake, essentially, and they stop in development. These sort of mistake cells end up developing and overdeveloping and taking over the blood to the point where all the good cells in your body, like your immune system cells, your platelets, all are essentially, they no longer can survive in your blood. These patients will be immunodeficient, when they'll easily bruise, very vulnerable to disease, bleed excessively. These are all problems of leukemia. So you have to look under the microscope and see if the cells that we're working with, called HL60 cells, you have to make sure that the cells aren't contaminated. We'll work in the hood, which is a sort of sanitary place where the cells won't get contaminated. We try to keep it as sterile as possible. All these cells, all these three flasks here are full of cells. And basically what I'm doing is, this is called cell medium. And it basically allows the cells to grow healthily without overgrowing. If we can somehow reverse effects and somehow maybe use miR-181c to target leukemic cells and essentially eliminate them from the blood cells, that would be a huge medical breakthrough. When I first came here, I didn't really know that much about hematology in general. I would just had the basic high school biology, chemistry, physics. But you know, working here, I've been exposed to so much. I've been exposed to hematology, leukemia, working it with medical research. And you know, it's just an experience that you're not going to find in a high school setting. This is something you really have to go out and sort of try to get yourself. And I also thought it would set me ahead when I applied to college and eventually to medical school, just to get an experience of what it's like to actually work in the medical field. Everyone in the lab has been extremely helpful with me to sort of find the best way to be efficient and to transfect the cells efficiently as possible.
Well, we just did cell transfection and it worked really well. The results from the PCR were pretty good, not as good as I hoped, but.
So it's been key to collaborate with them because they have the best understanding of which methods to use, how they can help me the best. I'm really passionate about medicine. I'm really passionate about the fact that you can help people so much in this industry. So I really think that if you're open and you really want to work and really want to understand everything that you work in the field that you work in, you'll be able to learn so much and you'll be able to excel, as you can go essentially anywhere.